best way to describe Beethoven's Third Symphony is probably with the word monumental. It's monumental in music history, it's monumental in Beethoven's own oeuvre. The first two symphonies of Beethoven were very much Beethoven-esque, but looked to Mozart and Haydn and were still embedded in the... It's monumental because this was something that was completely new. It's monumental for its length. The first movement tonight, or this afternoon, is about 15 minutes long, because we're not taking the repeat. It's monumental in the first movement because of these blows, these strikes that you hear, is sforzati, and you'll hear them in the first two opening chords. They're just extremely striking. I don't think we can grasp them now in this day and age because we've heard so much. But back in that day, it must have just been like mind-boggling and mind-blowing. And these sforzados, these blows, these punches, these little jabs go throughout the whole movement, even in the second theme, which is supposed to be the lyrical theme. But there's always these accents on, and it's usually on beat two. And Beethoven just uses that throughout the movement. It's like this little jab that goes on, or this big strike down. The second movement is a funeral march. It's actually a march in trio. So a minor opening funeral march, and then it leads into this major trio, this really haunting, beautiful, and again, monumentally long second movement compared to what had come before then. And in the middle of that, please pay attention, there's this amazing double fugue that is just so dramatic and so filled with pathos, and it just drifts with Beethoven. The third movement is the scherzo, and here we need to get a little bit back to some semblance of normalcy, scherzo and trio, but it's marked in the trio by this wonderful fanfare for three horns. And then in the last movement, Beethoven now kind of looks back with a theme and variations, and it's not all straightforward. It starts off with gusto, and then we have the strings playing around a little bit, and finally we hear this melodic, this really beautiful melodic melody with the ends when they come in. And just when you think things are building to a climax, Beethoven stops us and then creates this very long, slow section for almost the remainder of the movement. Gorgeous. And again, typical Beethoven. And then we end with this wonderful flourish in the coda. So here's Beethoven, Symphony number 3.
Thank you. Thank you. Thank you. Thank you.